Hello friends, in this world we see that we have lots of mental tension. Today this is Pranesh Mishra. I would like to say few points to my students or my friends how to overcome mental stress and tension. Often we see that we bring our problems from the office to the house. Suppose I am from my office bringing my tension to my house and I am saying one message, today I am in stress, I am in tension. Then my wife listens it and she can say to the children that don't go near Papa because he is in tension. I have spread my tension. If my wife will not talk to me, if my children will not talk to me, will my tension increase or decrease? I am not here to deliver some speech on mental tension. But I have to say that how to overcome this mental stress very easily. According to Hindu philosophy, we say, khud ko jay kare. According to Muhammadanism, there comes jihad word in Quran. There say one positive thing that jihad-e-akbar means to win yourself, to fight with yourself. And why to fight with others? I think religion is a great science and we must follow any one religion. If you are a God-fearing man, you will have less tension. For example, if you pray God, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah this way, or O God give us bread this way, or Tvameva Mata Chapita Tvameva, Tvameva Bandhu Chaskha Tvameva, anyway, then you will find the ultimate source, the Almighty, around you, and you will have a great peace of mind. After all, we are thy children. खुद को जीतना एक अभ्यास के जैसा ही है. जैसे आपको गुस्सा आता है तो आप क्या करते हैं? क्या आप उसको एक्सप्रेस कर देते हैं? In one way, expressing wrath, anger, gussa is also necessary. But just we have to change the way. Where, why, and when. Often we want to be master of all trades. We want to say that I can do all the work. And we lead to multitasking. At first, multitasking gives us very good result. Our boss says that yes, the person can do this work also, that work also, but slowly it increases our mental tension, nothing more. So just handle one work at a time. By doing multitasking, you will find very soon that you are unable to give perfection in all the works. And it's not possible. Just a very famous line that keeping your one leg in one boat and another leg in the other boat. How can it be possible, my dear? Every evening, plan what you have to do tomorrow. Chalk out what you have to do tomorrow. That will help you to tick the solved problems, the solved tasks. See your problems as if the problem is of your friend, not yours. How can you suggest easily to your neighbor and friend? But when you are indulged in the problem yourself, then you find yourself weak. Same thing happens with you or me. See this world as if you are not indulged in this world. You are infinite. You are powerful. You are not that ordinary piece of person. As Vivekananda has said that there is infinite background and support for you as a your religion and God. Someone is behind you. Your parents are behind you. Their blessings are behind you. You are not weak. How can you be weak when you have 2 feet and 2 hands, 2 eyes to perceive? A man, a woman, or any creature who can think, who has mind, can never be weak. Never. There are many desires, and unfulfilled desire is mother of anger. And when anger is in practice, that is disastrous and that brings us jeopardy. We have to train our brain how to relax. We should master the way of relaxation. There may be many ways of relaxation, as sometimes you listen to music, you go to swimming, you read any good book, you meet your friends. And nowadays, we are far from these things because of CDBG schedule. One thing happened that we do multitasking and overwork. We bring our files to our home to do the work only because we want increment every year so that our boss will say that the person is working hard. But as a result, what is the real enjoyment? Why are you working is left behind. You find your children not reading, not leading, and you repent. Views may be different, but what I think that office work should be dealt in office, that should not be brought home.